The passing of Queen Elizabeth II has been met with mixed emotion for Māori. Her history with Māori and Aotearoa is a poignant one. The late monarch was the first reigning sovereign to ever visit New Zealand, attending three Waitangi Day anniversary events during her reign. Tensions have existed between Māori and the Crown, although despite the fraught relationship, the Queen's death prompted Māori leaders to pay their respects. Her passing has seen the Kiingitanga, the Māori King movement, pay tribute to the close relationship the late British Queen shared with the late Māori Queen, Te Ariki Nui Dame Te Ātairangi Kahu. Joining us now for more on this relationship and the future of Aotearoa in the Commonwealth, we're joined by Kiingitanga's Ngira Simmonds. Morena I te rangatira, nau mai, whakatau mai ki Parakuihi. Welcome to breakfast. As I said in the introduction, within hours of the Queen's passing, Kiingitu Heitia released a statement talking about the sorrow of the Kiingitanga of her loss, which speaks to the relationship between the Kiingitanga and the Queen. Can you talk to us about that relationship?
Morena, Jenny May. Aye, absolutely. It starts, the relationship between the two institutions starts before Queen Elizabeth and does start from a position of land confiscation and invasion. But I think one of the things that Queen Elizabeth did in her reign is really change the narrative and change how we interact with each other. From a Kiingitanga perspective, we say mana to mana, ariki to ariki. So when she came here in 1953, she was greeted at Turanga Waiwai Marae by the then Princess Piki in the reign of King Koroki. And in that moment, there was, as things like that often go, quite well planned, quite well prepared. Everyone knows what everybody's supposed to do. And Queen Elizabeth changed what was supposed to happen. And she decided that she would respect the invitation of King Koroki and Princess Piki on behalf of Te Iwi Māori and come into Mahinarangi Whare. That was the beginning. It's quite a small action, but the beginning of many engagements over many years that saw Te Ariki Nui Te Ātairangi Kahu, our late Queen, I think, and in my words, come to love and really appreciate Queen Elizabeth and her reign and the things that she did to change the narrative for Māori people.
So back in 1953 is which the moment that you're talking about, Princess Piki, that was Dame Te Ātairangi Kahu, ne?
That's right, yes.
Aye. Yeah, and so 1953, and then in 1974, the Queen returned to Turanga Waiwai Marae, and that relationship continued, right?
Absolutely. She came back again at the invitation of our Queen and opened our wharekai. Now, from a Māori perspective, that's a very, very significant thing to do because that wharekai, to this very day, opens on every occasion and feeds manuwhiri, feeds the guests of the Kiingitanga and of our King on every single occasion. And so every person that comes through that door walks past the plaque that acknowledges that it was Queen Elizabeth and Prince Philip and Princess Anne that all together opened that whare. Another significant action acknowledging the close relationships that were forged over these years between Queen Te Ātairangi Kahu and Queen Elizabeth.
Can we talk about 1995? And the significance of Queen Elizabeth personally signing the Waikato Raupatu or Confiscation Settlement Act, the only New Zealand legislation given royal assent in person by the Queen. Talk to us about how monumental that was, and again, the apology that was given directly to Te Ariki Nui, Dame Te Ātairangi Kahu.
Kiingitanga kaumātua in describing that moment speak of a queen-to-queen relationship, a queen-to-queen respect, and a queen-to-queen friendship. It was, and still is, and always will be, an incredibly profound moment. And I think, as I mentioned earlier, there is a tension that exists for Te Iwi Māori and Indigenous people all around the world, absolutely. I think what we also need to be really aware of in considering that tension is every iwi that's been through the settlement process, every iwi that's received an apology, that entire process from the Crown's perspective exists under the mana of Queen Elizabeth. She did sign into law the Waikato settlement and offer that apology personally to Te Ariki Nui Te Aotearangi Kahu. But that entire process, the New Zealand government oversees on behalf of the Crown. And so there is something of a restoration there. And the wrongs are more institutional, but Queen Elizabeth was very quick to be there in person to do all she could do to right that wrong. It's a hard thing. Please, I don't want to give the impression that we've all just moved on. It's not. It's incredibly difficult. But Queen Elizabeth was very unique and very special in how she approached that entire kaupapa. The other day, Sir Tipene O'Regan was on the television equally speaking about her contribution for Ngaitahu.
Tēnā koe, tēnā. Because as you say, Māori have mixed emotions and reactions to the Crown, which is understandable, and we shouldn't ignore those grievances. But, you know, we're a iwi of manaakitanga and of love, and there have been some real treasured moments over time, and I guess I'm talking about times at Waitangi, but also probably in this context, more with the Kiingitanga and Te Ariki Nui and Queen Elizabeth herself, right?
Absolutely, and in those moments, as King Tuheiti's private secretary, I don't mind sharing a little bit with the nation. One of the things that's really difficult to manage is when your sovereign or your monarch decides they want to stay longer than planned. And those of us in the background responsible for all the details go into an utter panic. Now, every time Queen Elizabeth came to Turangawawa, and in fact any member of the House of Windsor have come to Turangawawa, they always stay longer than scheduled. And in this modern context, in the role that I have now, I stand and smile as I watch their secretaries and staff behind them panic, because I know how that feels on my side. But again, it speaks to the aroha, the manaakitanga, what they feel when they come to Turangawawa, how they feel respected and loved and cared for, but equally their respect for the Kiingitanga. And of course, the Kiingitanga seeks to represent not just Waikato, but all the people chosen by the motu to carry this title. Waikato looks after it, but it is a taonga, a treasure of all of Te Iwi Māori. That's the quality, that's the relationship, and we are absolutely certain that in the reign of King Charles III, we will continue to grow from strength to strength, because King Tuheitia and King Charles are close friends.
He segue pai tēnā, because I was going to ask you about that in terms of that relationship between the Kiingitanga, or Kiingi Tuheitia, and King Charles, because they have met before. So you talk about them being friends. What is that relationship going to look like going forward?
I think it will continue in the vein of Queen Elizabeth and Queen Te Aotearangi Kahu. I think there'll be mana to mana, ariki to ariki, and a deep respect and understanding of what it means to lead your people, to offer guidance, to offer manaakitanga, and in a very kingitanga perspective, a korowai. The kingitanga is a korowai, so it seeks to protect and shelter and wrap around and envelop Te Iwi Māori with all of the fruits of our culture and with all of the gifts that we try and bring primarily for unity at the end of the day.
Hei whakatepe ake tā tātou kōrero I te atanei. Just to wrap things up this morning, I wondered if you could share with us how the Kiingitanga will pay tribute to the Queen over the coming weeks. Is there anything planned?
Yeah, absolutely. Our first response is always karakia, and so we have been having karakia, having times of prayer and reflection privately. We are respecting the tikanga that the Queen's funeral service in England should be the first official public memorial service. So our more public engagements will take place after that. We're also in the steps of finalising having Kiingi Tuheitia travel to the United Kingdom to attend the funeral in person also.
Nei rā te mihi ki a koe. Nau i rangatira e tā tātou hōtaka i te atanei. Thank you for lifting the mana of our show this morning. He mihi aroha tēnei ki a koe, Ngira Simmonds. Personal Secretary, Spokesperson, Archdeacon for the Kiingitanga. Tēnā koe.
Kia ora.